you walk into a mall and purchase an expensive branded bag. But soon enough, you realize that the bag is a knockoff. Would you sue the mall? Surely not. You would raise your concerns with the shop and probably sue them if all else fails. But what if you bought this bag on Flipkart or Amazon or eBay? Who would you approach to complain about a fake product in this case? Because on these online malls, you don't even know who the seller is. Shivani Saxena reports on the growing concern of counterfeits in the online world and if marketplaces can be held accountable for them.
Last year, India spent over $33 billion on purchasing goods and services online. That number is expected to increase tenfold by 2025. And with it, the problem of counterfeit goods. Skechers, Nulli Silk and even Louis Vuitton are amongst the many brands that have moved the courts complaining of online counterfeit goods sales and violation of their intellectual property rights. Can online marketplaces such as Amazon and Alibaba be held legally responsible for this? After all, they are just intermediaries, allowing buyers and sellers to connect. Experts say that counterfeiters are easier to catch in the brick and mortar world.
With the World Wide Web, the problem has become more complicated because of the anonymity. People are operating behind a veil of secrecy. It's exceptionally hard to identify individuals, track them, know their assets, know what they're earning, and therefore, the problem becomes exacerbated because of that. And one way, of course, to one facet of that problem has been where online marketplaces have been pleaded as defendants in lawsuits.
That may be because the sale of counterfeits online can be more damaging to the brands.
From their perspective, if physical goods were sold at physical locations and they were sold at some kind of remote street corner, the brand doesn't get as affected as suddenly if it is sold online, where you're talking about a million users suddenly getting to see something which is getting sold online. And therefore, online is something that's more worrying for them.
But does Indian law address this worry of brand owners? The Information Technology Act governs online transactions and lays down specific rules regulating intermediaries. The three most important ones in this case are that the intermediaries must warn sellers against violation of the intellectual property rights of others. It must not knowingly allow such violation to take place. And if such a violation comes to light, the intermediary is legally obliged to take down the information or product within 36 hours.
The brand owner actually is able to identify a specific instance of infringement and tell and inform the intermediary. Then the intermediary has to expeditiously remove, any content or link on its website which infringes somebody's intellectual property. But so long as there is there's no specific instance of infringement, a mere generalized knowledge may not be enough to impugn liability on them.
The expectation from law is that you have made some efforts to try and figure out if what is there is genuine. And if you don't make any of those efforts and simply say, no, I didn't know, that's not good enough. But if you make those efforts and then you simply cannot come to know that something is infringing somebody else's IP or something is fake, then you're absolved from liability. As soon as someone else then tells you that it is actually infringing, you are supposed to pull it down. So that's the expectation of law.
Knowledge and liability were at the center of a Delhi High Court ruling in 2016. In the Kent RO Systems case, Kent sued a competing manufacturer of water purifier for infringing its proprietary rights under the Designs Act, since the two purifiers looked alike. It also held eBay responsible for selling these infringing products on its website. On receiving the legal notice, eBay removed the specific products that Kent had complained against. But Kent wanted more. It asked eBay to identify and remove all other water purifiers similar to Kent's. eBay said that was unreasonable. The court agreed with eBay and held that an intermediary cannot be expected to do such screening. This decision reinforced and clarified the expectations from an intermediary.
And the courts have held that this is all that should be the expectation from intermediaries. Intermediaries also have to do business. You cannot expect them to have an absolute liability if someone else puts up something which is violative of a third party's intellectual property right. To the extent that they can and technology allows them to weed out such infringing goods, they should do it. But it is very unreasonable to expect them to be able to figure out every intellectual property violation, because the technology that exists today and the technology that ever exists, for example, if you're looking at figuring out if some jeans are a counterfeit Armani jeans, I mean, technology today doesn't exist that you can just use some technology and just figure out that this is not the right this thing. So it's the intermediaries then, or the online marketplaces then, will have to stop doing business. And you know, nobody wants that. And the courts have said that we have to give interpret the law and put obligations on them such that they're reasonable. They can still carry on business. At the same time, they just do not pretend that are absolutely helpless, and at every instant they simply say, I don't know.
The question of an intermediary's knowledge becomes more pertinent when these e-commerce players play a bigger role than just that of a marketplace. For instance, Amazon often stores goods in its warehouse and distributes them via the Fulfillment by Amazon program. Flipkart tags some of its products as Flipkart Assured, or quality products delivered fast. Lawyers say that these additional services attract greater liability.
Specific cases in which the intermediary or the online marketplace will be held guilty for contributory or secondary liability. One case, of course, is when an online marketplace makes an assurance vouching for the authenticity of the goods sold on its marketplace. If it says that we vouch for we authenticate or rather we guarantee that the goods sold on the marketplace are in fact 100% genuine goods. Now, when that kind of an affirmative statement is made by them, we can certainly presume that they have actual knowledge, they have the requisite level of control over their merchants and over their sellers. And it would really amount to a misrepresentation if, despite making that representation, counterfeit goods are actually found on the website.
But there's a twist. Foreign direct investment policy does not permit foreign-owned e-commerce players to offer warranty or guarantee on goods and services sold on its website, says Sunith Katarki. Hence, any additional promise is illegal to begin with, and there may be no recourse against it.
That's unfortunate to an extent in the context of a consumer, because while the FEMA was framed around ensuring that these guys are not doing retail sale and are being only marketplaces, to an extent the assurance therefore gets diluted from a purchaser's perspective, because he is therefore not really getting an assurance on the product itself, and therefore has limited rights to be able to take these online marketplaces to court and say that, your assurance, you gave me an assurance, but this is a counterfeit good, therefore you are liable. Yes, there is a bit of a dichotomy there, so to speak, caused by the foreign exchange law and what would ideally have been the law in terms of intellectual property and contract. When someone says, I assure you of this product, then you should be able to stand by it.
Experts say that many have tried to attribute more than just intermediary liability on online marketplaces, but so far, none have been successful. But the law in relation to intermediaries is still evolving. Meanwhile, your claim against Amazon's and Flipkart's for sale of cheap knockoffs could still succeed with the help of laws like tort and consumer protection. Until next time, keep shopping. This is Shivani Saxena for Bloomberg Quint, Mumbai.
With increasing digital spends, the problem of counterfeits is likely to become bigger too. That's all that we have on this episode of The Fine Print. Thank you for joining us. We'll see you next week.